So as I said, this is cash money and this is big money.
Big money.
Big money right here. Woo-hoo!
Drew Holiday got paid. Over the past week, the Bucks made waves amongst the NBA community when it was announced that Drew Holiday signed a four-year, $160 million extension. I feel like the overwhelming majority of Bucks fans were stoked about the extension, but the reaction amongst the overall NBA community was that the Bucks overpaid Drew. I think that couldn't be further from the truth. Drew Holiday is worth every penny of his extension for the Bucks, and I'll explain why from a dollars and cents perspective, from an on-court perspective, and from a culture perspective. First thing I want to address about Holiday's extension is that it's not really a four-year, $160 million deal. The deal is actually 4 years, $135 million, with $25 million in incentives. Holiday has an average cap hit of about $33.5 million per year for the first 3 years of the extension. Then the hit will grow to $38 million if Drew picks up his player option in 2024. Drew's cap hit next season will be $31 million, ranking him around 30th in the NBA, just behind guys like Andrew Wiggins and Kevin Love, ranking him well behind players like Kemba Walker, Pascal Siakam, and Kristaps Porzingis. Also, if you go look at the guys getting paid right behind Drew, you'll struggle to find a lot of players who are better. And I think the only guys making less than Drew that are better than him are players on their rookie deal like Luka, or players who are just kicking into their rookie extension like Tatum and Mitchell. Maybe you could count LaVine, maybe Vucevic, I don't think so, but some people might. Outside of Drew being worth the money he got paid compared to what other similar players are making, I want to make the point that the Bucks didn't have cap space. They didn't have space with Drew, and they wouldn't have had space without Drew, so it made sense to use his bird rights to sign him. The NBA salary cap is set at $112 million for the 2021-22 season. The Bucks have Giannis set to make $39.3 million, Chris set to make $35.5 million, Brooke $13.3 million, Dante and Pat set to combine to make $10 million, and then you have Merrill and Nwora set to combine for just shy of $3 million. These seven players alone put the Bucks' guaranteed salaries at 101.1, or less than $11 million shy of the cap before you even take into account Drew's contract. Then you have guys like Bobby Portis and Brin with player options, and I assume the Bucks will want to re-sign PJ, Thanasis, and Mamadi. Like I said, the Bucks were not going to have any cap space to be players in this year's free agent class, so the smart move was to use Drew's bird rights to re-sign him for the long term, especially if you take into account the massive haul the team gave up to get him. If y'all ever heard anyone say no marquee free agents will ever come to Milwaukee, well, that's especially true if the Bucks don't have money. Not only is Drew worth the money individually, but his fit with this Bucks team is seamless. Drew Holiday has shown Bucks fans what they've been missing with Eric Bledsoe at the helm for these past seasons. Drew is a three-level scorer that can kill smaller guards in the post, nail jumpers in the mid-range, and he could shoot from deep. I mean, he could shoot. Did y'all know he could shoot like this? As of recording the video, Drew is putting up 17.4 points per game on 51% shooting from the field and 40% shooting from deep, but expect those numbers to keep rising. Ever since being reinserted into the starting lineup on March 11th, Drew's increased his scoring to 21.4 points per game on ridiculous shooting splits of 54.8% from the field, 45.6% from three, and 90.6% from the free throw line. Drew's ability to get a bucket has really surprised me so far this season. His 0.91 points per possession on isolations rank him ahead of guys like LeBron, Devin Booker, and Jason Tatum, and his 1.2 points per possessions on post-ups put him in the 88th percentile in the league, according to Synergy Sports. Drew is starting to assert himself in the Bucks' offense, and it's looking like he could be a reliable top three option come playoff time. Don't forget the last time in the playoffs when he absolutely dominated Dame and CJ while putting up almost 24 a game. While Drew has never been your prototypical playmaking point guard that averages 10 assists, that's not the kind of player the Bucks need. Budenholzer and the Bucks run a Spurs-Warriors-esque system that relies on multiple playmakers rather than one primary playmaker. Drew can absolutely provide enough playmaking to fill in that role. Drew is a huge upgrade as a playmaker and overall decision maker over Bledsoe. I've come to actually expect Drew to come through in the clutch, rather than have late game meltdowns like Bledsoe does. The switch from Bled to Drew didn't just increase the Bucks' offensive rating by over 5 points per 100 possessions, but he also increases the Bucks' defensive ceiling. Drew is one of the best defensive players in the league, not just according to analytics and steals, but according to the best players around the NBA.
Drew Holiday is solidified as probably the best defender in the league at the guard position.
He guard me. He's the best defender in the league. Like, out of the guards, I think he's the best defender.
I don't think he underrated, but Drew.
Yeah, everybody Drew, says.
Man, listen, everybody Drew says that.
Holiday has taken upon some of the toughest defensive tasks in the NBA over the past couple of seasons. Consistently guarding opposing teams' best players, and the Bucks are going to need that level of perimeter defender because for the foreseeable future, the Eastern Conference will run through Brooklyn, and the Bucks will need guards that can bother Kyrie and Harden and sometimes even switch on to Kevin Durant.
I gained a lot of respect for him in that series because he went from guarding me to Klay to Steph to guarding Draymond, neutralizing pick and rolls. Like, he's special. He's special on that side of the ball.
Holiday's size and strength also gives the Bucks better opportunities to switch screens on the defensive end. Holiday is in a league of his own as a two-way guard. Very few, if any, perimeter players have had the responsibilities that Drew has had on the offensive and defensive end over the past few seasons. So far this season, the Bucks are 27-12 in games that Drew plays and 5-6 in games he doesn't. Drew has carried the Bucks' offense at times. He's hit game winners, other clutch shots, and he's leading the league in steals, all while figuring out his role. Drew hasn't just integrated himself with this team, but he's become an integral piece of this roster in just over 6 months. Drew Holiday is the kind of guy you want to root for. Last season, Drew won the Twyman Stokes Teammate of the Year Award for his work on and off the court. He donated his salary from the NBA Restart to his charity, the Drew and Lauren Holiday Social Justice Impact Fund that aims to combat systemic racism and address social and economic inequalities. Then in December this season, he announced that he was donating the remainder of this season's salary to support small, black-owned businesses, nonprofits, and initiatives. Don't be surprised if a large chunk of this extension is given back to the community. And back in 2016, Drew missed the beginning of the season to help care for his newborn and wife recovering from brain surgery. Holiday is legitimately one of the most likable guys in the NBA. Add him to the list, and the kind of player you want to root for. The Bucks are not just building a team, but they're building a culture, and Drew Holiday is built for that culture. Drew Holiday is worth every penny of his extension. The Bucks paid Drew what he was worth on the open market. His fit in Milwaukee has been almost perfect. And looking towards the future, the Bucks will need a player like Holiday as they try to make it past the three-headed monster in Brooklyn. And lastly, if you're a Bucks fan, I think you should be excited that we get to root for an amazing person for the next 4 years.
So, Bucks fan, I'm a Buck for life.
This is he's a Buck for
look,
life.
Come on, my last.
No. He's a Buck for life.
Thanks for checking out the video, guys. Please drop a like or comment if you enjoyed the video, as it really helps the channel grow. Are y'all as excited about the Holiday extension as I am, or do you still think it's an overpay? Let's talk about it in the comments below. I'm still working on the video about the Nassus's evolution, and Jeff Teague's play has actually changed my mind about the signing. So if you're a Bucks fan, keep your eyes peeled for when I post those videos. But either way, I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.
Good for the lead. Drew Holiday for the victory!